Alright, this is Efren from Godsized, and you're watching and listening to Total Rock.
So how's the rest of the tour been? You've obviously been on tour with Black Label Society for a week now. Any stories for us?
Can't remember.
It's been amazing, the tour's been amazing. I mean, it's like we couldn't have asked to be treated better at all by those guys. I mean, the guy who just opened the door and trying to ruin it.
If you see us laughing, that's because Nick from Black Label was just leaning around the door.
And pulls a weird face, but we didn't know if we'd see those guys. You know, we didn't. They could be very easy to not see them at all. And they've just been hanging out and just, you know, Zach's hilarious. He's doing an Aussie impression every 5 minutes and all this sort of stuff. But it's just, it's been really cool. You know, they've been looking after us so well and, you know, couldn't have asked any better from the crowds either, you know. Been going down great every night.
So when you got the phone call saying, hey, you've got a support slot with Black Label Society, what did you do?
I freaked out. I mean, our manager called us and said, he called me and said, are you sitting down? And I was like, yeah, go on. And he said, right, you've got a UK tour with Black Label. And I was like, amazing, man. He goes, and it's just you two bands. And I was like, what? And then a week later, he phoned back and said, oh, you're never going to believe this. They have phoned back and offered us the rest of the Europe tour, so another 4 weeks with them. All around Europe, and I was, you know, you can imagine we're an unsigned band, so it's like
you can't ask for a sweeter
deal.
It's
you know, amazing, yeah.
Well, I'm really looking forward to seeing you guys because the last time I saw you was when you closed the LA 2. You played the last night.
Yeah,
I literally closed it.
Yeah, how does it feel to be the last band to play there?
Oh,
that's super cool. Yeah. Isn't it?
I just hope we didn't have a hand in closing it.
I seriously think the decision should be made before you guys.
Yeah, well, you know, when the venue's going downhill, when you have bands like us turning up and playing it, but no.
Well, they only just managed to save the 100 Club just after we played there as well. So. Sorry, Hammersmith.
So you've been pretty busy since then. So give us a little bit of a history of what you've been up to the last couple of years.
Playing.
We've done about 250-ish shows in those 2 years. Just been out and about, and we you know, we're an unsigned band, we've got day jobs, so it's just fitting them in and around life. So, but that's kind of our ethos. We're like a live band, play as far away as possible as we can, and you know, there's no point being a big fish in a small pond type scenario where you know you play your local 50 miles, you know, every few months you go to that venue. So we sort of really concentrated on just getting out there as much as possible. So that's what we've been focusing on. You know, that was the whole, we were a live band, that's what we view ourselves as. Put a couple of EPs out in the time, so as well, but yeah.
And what's your highlight of the last couple of years been?
Well, download was
to this point,
And probably this.
Yeah, tonight, you know, fighting all goes well. Yeah, ask us again in 2 hours or something.
If you'd have asked us a week ago, it would have been download ringing out. But now this tour as a whole, you know, every show has been amazing on this tour so far. I mean, you know, the audiences have been amazing. You know, it's a bit like you have to pinch yourself, you know. And there's been a few little mishaps and disasters on the way and that you're always going to get there on something like this. But it just makes it all worthwhile, you know, 45 minutes on stage in front of those people. And the minute we always, like, you know, as soon as we get off stage, we just get another beer and then head out to the crowd. And then just hanging out in the merch booth and meeting everyone and just talking, you know, the amount of people that come up and say, didn't know who you were and absolutely love your band now. And, you know, and that's what you want. That's the whole point of doing this, you know. So,
another person has been very, very complimentary about you as well. And that's JD. I just had a catch up.
Slipping that tenner later.
And I asked him what he thought about you guys, and he thought you were awesome.
That's amazing, so, man. That's really nice to hear. All the guys in the band are absolutely the coolest guys, you know.
Excuse me. Oh, I can't believe someone left their phone on.
Oh, dear.
Dear me.
No, JD was actually last night in soundcheck. He was playing. We were soundchecking, and he came out. He was like playing your bass.
He was just
like
showing you some licks and
stuff. Because the guy's a killer player as well, you know, he's absolutely amazing. But yeah, that's the sort of the way these guys are, you know. We'd be in the middle of soundcheck and like Nick Hannes would walk out and he'd be like, just everyone has to stop and he's just chatting to you, showing you pictures on his mobile phone and stuff like that.
Just today, when we were soundchecking today, Zach just comes out on stage and just starts talking to me about Dorian Yates and people like that. It's just, you kind of get lost that this is, you know, the guy that you're talking to, who he is and what he's done.
Legend, yeah.
Because they're just so chilled out and easy to get along with.
Yeah.
I
don't know. Well, guys, have a great show tonight. Cheers, best of luck for the rest of the tour and catch up with you when you're back.
Thank you very much. Yeah, cheers. You.